Well, good afternoon from New York. Today, this time, inner mind communication, the view from your inner artist. Your inner artist is super cool, okay? It's the part of you that's outside of your dramatic sense of time, the things that are important in the past and the future. It's outside of it. It can look down on your story, the movie of your life, and encourage you. It doesn't matter, you know, you're a good guy, a bad guy, whatever in the story. It's a great story. From the artist's perspective, all stories are good because, you know, your artist is always, in a sense, appreciating everything in life, so in bliss and heaven, but in a sense looking down from heaven. And encouraging you to be the hero of love in that story. And saying, wow, what a great story. This is an amazing story. What if you were to rise up and be the hero of love in that story? The inner artist in you is the part of you that creates all the roles that you play in life. It creates the part of you that is your objective empathy, that part of you that is planted by reason of prediction into the future. You know, helping you to get to a better space, a better place. Helping you with your anxieties for the present, looking into the future. Encouraging you to move forward. And that's an extension of the artist. Another extension of the artist is it's the imaginer of your imagination. Is the role that helps you to heal from anxieties from the present, looking into the past. That part of you that helps you to actually relive that past, in a sense, and overcome any damage, faith, and love that's associated with it. But not just that. Helping you to embrace the beautiful things in your experience in the past that you may have overlooked. So there are treasures to be found. And your artist is also playing that role for you. And the artist also plays the role that it's you. Now, that's in the mythology of Vaishnava Hinduism, but it's this eternal, in the dualist factors, this eternal relationship between yourself and this absolute personified truth, the artist, your inner artist. Krishna is speaking as this ultimate source of all love and so on. Since he's in your heart, you know, well, yeah, of course. That's your inner artist. Jesus says, if you let me into your heart, you know, if anyone will, you know, we're going to have dinner together. we're going to know each other. So the artist wants you to embrace that vision of the supreme creator of all that you imagine to be real. It's a beautiful experience. So even the part that you're playing as the dramatic self in your timeline, that kid in you, I call it, that's where the biggest emotional impact occurs. You know, the more survival impact. That's in a sense a kind of oneness between that inner artist and that dramatic self. Just as Jesus said, I pray that these shall be, you know, one with me as I am one with you, in his prayer. Wow. Well, the inner artist is the image of that supreme, absolute truth personified that lives in your heart. It's you. In a sense, it's even the real you. But the dramatic part of you is the one enjoying and experiencing the drama. And it could be a horror show, it could be any number of things, but there's a part of you that can watch it all and go, wow, that's a very enjoyable story. That's fun to watch. I felt that. Wow, what a roller coaster. Yeah. So, and hey, it's like tossing a baby up in the air and catching it so it goes, hey, you're okay. That's what a dad does right there. Well, mama goes, yeah, well, daddies are important too. You know, so the kid knows, hey, I had this experience and I'm all right. You know. Oh, wow. So, that's this inner artist is super cool. It is the part of you that can create experiences for you. You know, the imaginer of all your imagination can create experiences for you that can become memories for you. All of these perspectives working together, that's the mystic path. But it goes deeper than that, too. There's a part of you that is before you had an ego. The part of the kid in you that is the infant that just has the abilities of awareness, relationship to needs, which are the core of communication. Always needs and desires, which is connected to me. This impulse, this awareness, is the life, the birth of all that you are. And it is before you had an ego. The infant view has the ability to, in relationship to its needs, doesn't have the
Alexa,
ability of the impotence, the forms of impotence, but it has the ability to be at play. Fish can play. Yeah, it has that much development, and also, so it can be playful, the baby can be playful, and it can
Alexa,
be expressive of
Alexa,
its needs.
And,
you know, also be, of course, focused and aware of its needs and feelings, but without, you know, words, just being in touch. That's the powerhouse of everything. It's the lotus in the pond that grows and becomes a social self and a spiritual self, a self that is on the path of amazing love. So that's the path from the view of the artist. Thank you for listening. And I hope that you find the artist within you. And whatever more there is to that, you find it. Trust me. You don't have to preach. You don't have to pound on a book and claim it's perfect. Just invite people to climb the mountain. The mystic mountain. The journey toward greater compassion, creativity, and objectivity. The journey toward greater awareness. That's the good news. And all of this is a bit of a self-sacrifice at points where you are growing in your capacity for these things and you're changing. And sometimes that can be a little uncomfortable. But if it's in your comfort range, it's like exercise. You gotta push yourself a little. But not too much. Just a little will do. And the more you exercise, the more you want to exercise. You know, it's same here. With this practice. And it even works in your dreams. Yeah. Your inner artist creates those dreams. So, I hope this view of the inner artist resonates with you. And this is all about the path, which is spiritual but not religious. Religion divides, spirituality unites, and the world right now needs to find unity. It needs to find a greater love. And let's hope that we do. As I like to say at the end of...
Okay, I'll be right back.
At the end of my meetings... my presentations, namaste, may that love flow within me, honor that in you, and have a great day, y'all.